Hi students, this is Roshan and today in this video we are going to discuss about the electrostatic potential energy of a dipole in a uniform electrical field. Okay, so this question is mainly about how a dipole behaves or to deal with the potential energy of the dipole when it is placed in a uniform electrical field. Okay, so mainly if a dipole, see this diagram, so mainly if a dipole, I am considering a dipole, see a plus charge and a minus charge get separated by a distance 2a apart. So if this is a dipole, if a dipole is placed in a uniform electrical field, means it creates an equal and opposite force. Okay, so that force may create a torque. This torque may tends to rotate the dipole. An important thing about the rotational force is that it moves with a constant velocity. Okay, so when the dipole gets rotated, we all know that the angle of the dipole gets changed. Okay, so listen guys, by the formation of a torque, the angle of a dipole changes from theta dash to theta. So this theta is the transferred angle. Okay, so that change in angle is the work done by the external force. This work done is represented as W is equal to torque external and d theta. So what is torque external? Because the work done is mainly depend upon the external torque only. Okay, so that I am referring it as a external torque, and d theta means a change in angle. So that change in angle may create a displacement. So I am referring tau into d theta. Okay, and here I am putting that theta dash to theta, which means initial angle is theta dash and the final angle, transferred angle, is theta. Okay, so by referring the formula for the torque experienced in the electrical dipole that we got checked in the previous videos, we all know that tau is equal to modulus of p vector cross E vector. Okay, so by substituting this torque value to that external torque, we get the W is equal to integral of theta dash to theta P E sine theta and D theta. So now you get a little bit confused why I'm using a sine theta, because there is no sine theta. So listen guys, in vector form, instead of cross symbol, you have to put sine theta only. Okay, if it is a cos theta, means you have to refer this as a dot symbol. Okay, so by taking PE as a constant term, because in integration we have to deal only with the terms what lies near D. So near D we have theta only, so we have to deal with only sine theta. So I am taking a PE as a constant term. Okay, so that becomes PE theta dash to theta, sine theta D theta. Okay, it's my mistake. Okay, so by integrating sin theta, we get minus of cos theta. Okay, so that W will becomes PE of minus cos theta. So the limit may be theta and theta dash. So in the place of theta, you have to replace it with the first, you have to replace it with the theta, and then you have to put a minus symbol and then replace it with the theta dash. Okay, upper limit minus lower limit. So that will become PE of minus cos theta, because in replacing theta by the theta, we get theta only, and minus of minus cos theta dash. Okay, and now you understand that gets transformed into PE of minus cos theta plus cos theta dash. Okay, minus cos theta plus cos theta dash. So this is the work done. So I'm changing it with the positive symbol, because I want the positive symbol to be placed in the first time. So I could change this into PE of cos theta dash minus cos theta. Okay, cos theta dash minus cos theta. So by seeing this formula, you get to clearly understand that the work done is mainly depend upon the change in angle between these two thetas. Okay, so that work done is equal to the potential difference between the change in angle of theta and theta dash. Okay, so the work done W is referred as the change in potential energy. So it can be written as U theta minus U theta dash. Okay, changing the final angle minus changing the, so it should be written as U theta minus U theta dash. That means the difference between the potential energy of theta and the potential energy of the theta dash, and it in simplified form it should be written as del U. Okay, so taking the value of W, we get minus PE cos theta plus PE cos theta dash. Okay, so if the initial angle, okay, if the initial angle theta dash, okay, listen that, if the initial angle theta dash is equal to 90 degree means, okay, we know that cos 90 is equal to 0, okay, cos 90 degree is equal to 0, so if the value should be substituted, we get u is equal to, so the del u will becomes minus PE cos theta plus 0, that's it, okay, so in simplified form, del u is equal to minus PE cos theta. So that's it. So in vector form, it should be written as del u should be written as u, that potential energy, okay, is u should be written as u minus p dot e, p vector dot e vector. So the reason for putting out dot here is that we are placing a cos theta, so in vector form you have to replace the cos theta by dot symbol. Okay guys, so listen guys, the potential energy in the system is mainly depend upon the changing theta. Okay, so it depends upon the changing angle of the dipole theta with respect to the external electrical field. Okay, if the dipole is aligned anti-parallel means, okay, if the dipole is aligned anti-parallel means the potential energy is maximum at any angle. Okay, so that theta is equal to pi. If it is anti-parallel means the angle of theta should be equal to pi, and it is minimum when it is aligned parallel to the external electrical field. Okay, if it's minimum means should be aligned parallel to the external electric field, and that is for theta is equal to 0 degree. Okay, so guys, it seems a really interesting topic today. Hope you all enjoy it. If you have any doubt in this topic and this question, ask me on the comment section. Give me a like, share. For daily videos, subscribe my channel. Daily videos are coming for you. Thank you guys. See you on the next class.